Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbil Alameen, Ya Rabb. Salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammad. Kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim. Wabarik ala Muhammadin wa ala Ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala Ali Ibrahim fil alameen. Innaka hamidun majid. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له صلى على نبيه فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه سيدي يا رسول الله روحي بحبك في الضياء تهيم والشوق مني في هواك عظيم والقلب مشوق بذكر محمد في ذكره نور وفيه نعيم صلى عليك الله يا علم الهدى ما هبت النسائم وما ناحت على الأيك الحمائم اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين آمنوا به وعزَّروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه أولئك هم المفلحون وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء سيدنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وارضى عنا معهم يا رب العالمين آمين ثم أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters It is my honor to welcome you all to the Fariḍa of Jumu'ah Today we'll be talking about a very serious matter that spread so widely on the social media Social media has a lot of benefits and also a lot of harm. So we have to be careful from where we take our information and which one we trust and which one we should not trust. The social media become the biggest village, or we can call it global village, that has more than 3.6 billion followers and expected to be 4.4 billion followers in the year 2025. Out of the human population, which is almost 8 billion human beings, it gives a lot of service. You can see the adhan being broadcast 5 times a day. It wake you up for Fajr. If you read the Quran, you read everything, books about all of that, you know what is going on in the world. But there are some kind of strategy that targeting the Muslims, especially the Muslim youth. From people, God knows, they do not have a faith or a little faith in their heart. They try to target the Muslims to disconnect them, from the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And sadly enough, even there are Muslims who are called themselves Quraniyun, the people of the Quran, as we do not need the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, Allah revealed to him, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum, wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati, wa raditu lakum al-Islam deena. Which means, this is the day I have perfected my favor to you. And completed my religion, and Islam become your religion, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed. So whatever happened after that, in a meaning that all the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were collected by the scholars like Bukhari, Muslim, An-Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, At-Tirmidhi, Abu Dawood, Malik, all of those nine collections of the hadith. They were written 300 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they have some fake or fabricated hadith. Why should we follow that? Quran is enough. So they say, whatever Allah say halal in the Quran, we consider it halal. Whatever Allah say haram, we consider it haram. But the sunnah, anything after that, we should not worry about it. That is not a part of Islam. And that is a big lie about Islam. Because as we know, the Islamic jurisprudence, the Islamic fiqh, and the sharia has been taken from the main two sources, the Quran, as well as the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the sunnah for the Quran is the twin of the Quran, the sister of the Quran. You cannot separate them as for their validity and authority. So the sunnah is as needed as we need the water and the air to breathe. There is no Islam without the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We cannot imagine that to read the Quran without going back to the sunnah, to see how Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understood that verse or decided on that matter, or how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam behaved in a certain situation. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran is swearing by himself in Surah An-Nisa 65. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. What does it mean? By your Lord. So Allah is swearing by himself as the Lord of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They will never be believers. It doesn't matter how they claim. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ until حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Until they judge you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in any affairs that emerging among them. So we cannot accept the people to say we are believers without accepting the authority of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And that is not enough. Some people might say, okay, but they have some doubt in their heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue in the same verse to say, وَلَا يَجِدُوا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةً مِمَّا أُوتُوا. They cannot find any narrowness in their heart after what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. This means you have to accept what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said with a smile, with pleasure, with acceptance. Then number three, وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. They have to surrender and to submit to the sunnah and the hadith and the decision of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Three conditions for the people to claim faith, to be say we are believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to who? To Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who delivered the Quran to us? Is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How can we listen to scholars, to imams, to sheikhs, without listening to the one who received the Quran and delivered the Quran as it is? How can that happen?
How can such people claim that they are Muslims? And they think that they are equal to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad was a man. Allah said about him, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ. He's mad like anybody. And we are men. It means Muhammad doesn't know better than us, which is very rude. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came back from the night journey, that is coming inshallah after 2 weeks, then the people started making fun of him. They went to Abu Bakr and said, Abu Bakr, come, see what Muhammad claimed, that Allah took him to the highest heaven. He went to Jerusalem in a part of the night. What did Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu say? In kana qala, faqad sadaq. He trusted Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the way. If he said, he must be saying the truth. Why Abu Bakr? Why you have that confidence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, innahu يُخْبِرُنَا بِأَنَّ الْخَبَرَ يَأْتِيهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. He came until us, Jibreel came down and delivered to me those verses. How cannot we trust him in a journey while we trust him as communicating between Jibreel and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So therefore, brothers and sisters, that claim is meant to disconnect the people from the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we look at the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he revealed the Quran, he said, وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. We revealed down the book to you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? What is the mission of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Just a delivery man, bring the Quran, say, take it, and I am done? No. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. That you may explain, that you may manifest, that you may teach the people, that you may exercise for them what have been revealed to them. لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. That is why, brothers and sisters, the notion that the Quran, the Sunnah was written 300 years. Yes, it was written in the 3rd century of the Hijrah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But who says there was no Sunnah before? The Sunnah was there from day one, memorized, practiced, narrated generation after generation. But the documentation of the Sunnah was in the 3rd century after the Hijrah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that is why those scholars, may Allah reward them greatly. They made a lot of effort to travel east and the west, 60 miles, to travel from Syria to Yemen, from Egypt to Iraq, from Iraq to all those, to make sure that they are so certain whenever they narrate the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, I have no problem to ask 30 people to make sure that this hadith is authentic. Ibn al-Mubarak, one of the great tabi'i, he said, the narration of the hadith narrated by so and so and so till they reach Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a part of our faith. لولا الإسناد لضاع الفقه. And you will never find a nation on this earth that have a science called علم الحديث, علم الإسناد, where they investigate the people, the narrator of the hadith, how trustworthy, how truthful, how reliable, how honest, have ever told a lie, Have they ever practiced any dishonesty? Even with the animals. If somebody lied to the animal, as come, I'm gonna feed you, and he doesn't feed him, they never took the hadith from him. Why? Because they said if he lied to the animal, he will lie about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even that far. That is why that chain of narration, until reach Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If there is one person in the middle that has been seen once as not good, not ethical, they disregard his hadith. But that, brothers and sisters, doesn't deny the fact. There are some weak hadith, there are fabricated hadith. And those hadiths are scattered all over. That is why better to make sure before sharing a hadith. Somebody send a message. Share this, very good for your faith. Allah will do this for you. Without reading, we share to a whole list on my phone. And we are spreading the hadith that no one knows if it is right or wrong. While the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, be careful. Be careful, make sure. من كذب علي متعمدا فليتبوأ مقعده من النار. Whoever lied about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will be said to him, have a seat designated for you in the hellfire. Because lying about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is lying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. Therefore, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, ati'u Allah. Follow the guidance of Allah, obey Allah. Wa ati'u Rasul. Allah didn't say ati'u Allah wa Rasul. Ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. It means there are some issues not mentioned in the Quran, not explained or detailed in the Quran, so you got to be look for them in the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul wa ulil amr minkum. Fa'in tanaza'tum fi shay'in. If you differ with one another about an issue, what should we do? فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. Refer it back to Allah and His Messenger. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the one who taught us the Quran, is the one that Allah entrusted him to explain the Quran to us. And the out of his authority, there are three kinds of revelation. The Quran, which is the miracle, the word of Allah to challenge mankind to the end of the time. And there is a Qudsi hadith, which is also from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but not as the give reward like reading the Quran, not as a miracle. It is a kind of wa'z, abdomission, to teach the people spirituality. And there is hadith, the authentic sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the meaning is from Allah, and the word is the word of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not worthy to follow, why he have to tell us about those things? Why he didn't say everything from God? Who can differentiate between this and that? But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. That is the reason Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not allow the people to write the hadith while the Quran was revealed, so they will never mix it together in one book. But it doesn't mean that we should forget about the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This kind of time, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about, أَلَا إِنِّي أُوتِيتُ الْقُرْآنَ وَمِثْلَهُ مَعْهُ. I have been given the Quran and the life of the Quran, which is the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A time will come when a man whose belly is full of food, يوشك رجل شبعان. شبعان means he is not in need. He is so rich. Sitting on his, reclining on his sofa or a chair, as to say, we have the Quran. Whatever the Quran say, we take it. Whatever the Quran say, haram, we stay away from. We don't worry about the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ألا وإن حديث محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم as important as the Quran. Otherwise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أقيموا الصلاة. That is what the Quran says. أقيموا الصلاة. Quran never explained to us how to make the salah, but the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. The Quran say, آتوا الزكاة. Give زكاة. How much to have and how much to give, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. When you come to Hajj, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أيها الناس, خذوا عني مناسككم. Learn how to perform Hajj and Umrah from me. Quran never mentioned that because a lot of details. And the Quran came with general rules. And the details are left to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted him. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون أو كما قال ادعوا الله يستجب لكم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونتوكل عليه ونستزيده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله السميع البصير وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا البشير النذير اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, be careful when you go to social media. Be careful what you read and what you share. Sharing is as I'm trusting in this kind of thing. So better to read it before or to ask before sharing it. You might share something that is a lie about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that was meant, as I said, to disconnect our children and ourselves from the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because they know that is the two guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَن تَضِلُّوا بَعْدِ أَبَدًا. Allah said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I left for you what if you follow, you will never suffer any misguidance. The first one is Kitabullah. Number two is the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So hold fast to the authentic Sunnah. It has an authority, validity. Do not listen to those who doubt it because they have no fiqh, and Allah knows even if they are Muslims, if they have faith or they don't have faith at all. Allahumma afir bi fadlika lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareebun mujibu du'a'i ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma la tad'a lana dhanban illa ghafartah wa la hamman illa farajtah ولا عيبا إلا سترته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا حاجة إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، أسأل الله الكريم رب العرش العظيم أن يغفر لي ولكم ولأمة محمد أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن